Welcome to the HPC IoTC workshop. My name is Julian Gunkel. I'm from the University of Reading. And the co-organizers of this workshop are Jay Lofsted from Sandia National Laboratories. Jay, can you say hello?
Hi, everybody.
And John Thomas Aquaviva from DDN. John Thomas?
Hello from Paris.
Wonderful. So IoDC stands for IO in the Data Center Workshop, and we have the sixth workshop iteration this year. Normally, we would be part of the IAC HPC Workshop Day, the Thursday, which can't take place, unfortunately, this year for the circumstances we know. But next year, we will offer it again, just that you know. So it's already a kind of a teaser to expect. I'm also very pleased that we do this instance as a virtual workshop to kind of prove that this is a really suitable approach to bring together the experts. So this workshop is powered by EasyWays, which is the Center of Excellence in Simulation of Weather and Climate in Europe, the Virtual Institute for IO, VI for IO, and the Journal of High Performance Storage. I will give a quick introduction to those sponsors. So this EasyWays, it is part of the Horizon 2020 program, one of the Center of Excellences. And EasyWays represents the European Community for Climate Modeling and Numerical Weather Simulation. Its goals in respect to HPC are to improve the efficiency and productivity for earth science applications, to support the end-to-end workflow of global earth system modeling, and to establish demonstrators that run those applications at highest affordable resolution. The Virtual Institute for IO is a web page and a community which has the goal to provide a platform for IO enthusiasts for exchanging information. It aims to support training and collaboration in the field of high performance IO. And we track and encourage the deployment of large scale storage systems, particularly by hosting lists about high performance storage systems, how they are deployed, and to raise awareness. Just to mention a couple of activities that we do in VI for IO. So together with the IO 500, we'll organize a Birds of a Feather session in July. Check out the webpage for detailed information. We now started a collaboration with the HPC Certification Forum, which you see the link here. The HPC Certification Forum has a goal to standardize HPC knowledge representation and to establish certificates attesting this knowledge and supporting an ecosystem around those competences. Check it out, it's really interesting, and we try to put in some IO-related competencies in the skill tree, which is still a way to go, but there will be a lot of skills necessary for IO expert that we know. Finally, we try in VI for IO, the activities is we try to capture file system specific characteristics more correctly, which is useful for this high performance storage list. And we try to explore how this can be used in the IO 500 as well. So the Journal of High Performance Storage, finally, it's a new journal. It just started basically this year. It has a couple of features. So we have open reviews in particular. So that means anyone can provide feedback to any paper. Anytime. We have the concept of living paper. That means papers can improve over time. So even if years later, theoretically, someone detects there is an issue or uncertain, something is unclear, needs to be more precise. So we want to add references from this paper, outgoing references to newer paper that cover this topic. That's something we try to do. We have an initiative for digital replicability. We will have a nice talk about the concept of replicability in the afternoon, in fact. This serves the purpose of replicating the analysis and the whole experiments. And it is free for the authors, and it's free for the readers. So it's totally free, it's open access. A couple of papers are available for review in what we call the incubator, which is this open review process before we accept it. And these are, in fact, the papers that we are, of which some we will see today. I'll say more about how this works in a minute. Now let's talk about HPC IoTC in particular. So when we started this workshop 6 years ago, we were looking in other workshops in other conferences, and realized oftentimes it's really about the individual application's performance. It's not about the perspective of the data center, which is slightly different, right? So one is the user that wants to get best performance, but how about the data center that needs to provide the best service and the best performance for a variety of users? And we know in a data center, those experts that work in a data center, they have a challenging task, right? They have to provide this good strategy for the users, but they have to look at a slew of emerging and existing storage solutions and technologies. They have to look to deal with a lot of different HPC file systems. They have to deal with large volumes and large numbers of files, petabytes, billions of files. They have to deal with higher level software that gets installed on top of their storage stack that they have to maintain. A lot of middleware software, right, provided by the users that interacts in some way. And finally, they have to understand what kind of I/O interactions are going on in the applications and in the workflows to really provide good service to the users. If you think about understanding systems and users, well, I can say, having worked at DKLZ about 10 years in my life, it's really challenging to understand what the users are doing and if that what they are doing is actually what they try to achieve. Often, the users don't even know their I/O patterns and the workflows they are doing because they have copied this from someone, potentially. However, if we had a perfect understanding of the usage of the system and the efficiency characteristics of our environment, we could select the right storage technology, we could make the best optimizations there where it's most beneficial instead of maybe edge cases that will lead to great publications, right? We want to understand the requirements for the next procurement, and we want to optimize the data center's efficiency as a whole. So as I/O is, I would say, the most challenging part in a HPC system, because it involves communication, it involves also the CPUs, and it's a distributed system, it's really challenging for the experts. And it's even more challenging for those experts to get the recognition they deserve, and the publications, for example, to make research in this area, because often people say, well, this is not, you know, proper research, this is just kind of use case. Well, it may improve 10% for the data center as a whole in terms of efficiency, this research is often neglected. That's really where this workshop aims to do. So we thought that it might be good to bring those experts together that all have done great individual efforts and activities, and maybe it can lead to better community efforts and, for example, conventions. So in this workshop, we bring together I/O experts from data centers, but also, because we are not excluding like users, they are in fact very welcome, regardless of file system, to really foster this information exchange and give you opportunity for networking. The topics of interest we have is, for instance, and it's not limited to, the scientific workloads, the user characteristics that you will see on those storage systems and systems in general, the systems perspective, like the data center perspective and the low level perspectives, system architectures, performance aspects and monitoring, and issues that arise, production and potential solution. And at this point, I will make a short break and give Jay and John Thomas the chance to also say something about the workshop. Maybe Jay, you want to start first?
Sure. The one thing that I like about this workshop compared to a lot of other venues is that we try to make sure that this becomes a strong community discussion effort so that we have a decent amount of time for us to look at what are the major issues that we're dealing with as a community rather than just having paper presentations. So in that sense, it's kind of a mix between a BOF and a workshop.
Great. Jen Thomas, you want to say something?
Yeah, so on my side, I would put the emphasis on the duality of the presentation. So there is expert talk and research paper. So I think it's very important to understand what is the reality of the issue. So the expert talk are really here to provide, I would say, a production level view of the problem that we need to solve, so we do not address a small or useless problem and we do not overlook important things. Thanks to this expertise, I think it's really key to understand what is really the landscape. And regarding the research paper, as you've mentioned previously, there is this journal that we are pushing for. So I would consider that a natural outcome for this research work would be to apply for a publication in this journal. So that would be my comment on this.
Great, thanks. So regarding the results of the workshop, of course, we will hopefully have some kind of outcomes instead of just presenting nice talks. The first of all is that the presentations itself, the PDFs of them, will be made available on the webpage. The videos that are created are generally be published on YouTube, and they will be linked on the webpage after the workshop, likely tomorrow, in fact. The research papers will be published in the Springer LNC format, so we will have 12-page short versions of the research papers in Springer, which is this joint, which is using a joint kind of post-conference proceedings published by ISC, but also as they are in the incubator where we do the review for the Journal of High Performance Storage, we are exploring if then they would be suitable for this journal in an extended version, and then they will be expected there as well. We will also write a preface to Springer LNCS publications and summarize the workshop results. Now, an important part of this workshop, as Jay has also mentioned, is basically the interactivity, because we try to bring people together. So we really like critical discussions, I would say. And I would say I actually expect them from our attendees. Maybe it's a German attitude to say things really straight if you find something confusing or if you have another idea. But this is a workshop, and we really try to put forward ideas and criticize our colleagues in a constructive fashion. That's the way of interaction, I hope. So if you have any questions regarding any talk, put these questions always in this Blackboard chat. Everyone can see, and you can start a discussion even during a talk. I'm not saying ever a talk would be bored, but I know that it can be very exhausting to listen for a couple of hours. So sometimes this is really good kind of break to discuss something with your colleagues. And the session chair will read the questions that are remaining at the end of the talk in the Q&A session, and they will be answered accordingly. Finally, we have also a Google Doc that you can find linked on the webpage, I hope. When you click on directly after the banner at top of the webpage, there is now a link to it. So you have to collect some ideas for the Q&A sessions. Of course, we have some ideas, I and Jay, who will moderate them, but it is really useful if you have anything to discuss, raise, put the ideas here, and we will continue the discussion. So this discussion will be ultimately controlled by a moderator, but you are free to unmute yourself as well, because you have the right to speak, and I don't expect any disturbance from that. So looking at our agenda, so this was the welcome. Our next session will then be moderated by Jen Toma. It will be a research paper session. So in the morning, we have research paper session, then we have research talks, we have an expert talk session, and then we have a virtual lunch break for an hour. So that's the only break. And then in the afternoon, we have again expert talks. We have a discussion slot, expert talks, and another discussion. So naturally, you place the discussions in the afternoon and early in the afternoon, because that we found makes the best use of the existing time for all our attendees. And that, without further ado, I give the words to Jen Toma. And basically, the first speaker can then unmute and share their screen. So thank you very much. I'm looking forward to having a great workshop with you.